For supplies, you will need a hoop, the colors that are in your pattern, plus one small string of a color that is not included in your pattern, scissors, an embroidery needle, the cross stitch fabric, and of course, the pattern itself. The first thing that you have to do is determine where the middle of this fabric is. And the way that we're gonna do that is by taking the fabric and folding it vertically first. And we're gonna crease along that edge and then horizontally. We crease that as well. So now we have the fabric broken into these four quadrants. And we are going to mark the stitch that is in the upper right-hand corner of the lower left-hand quadrant. And I'm going to come out from the bottom. You can see that I'm coming from the bottom left-hand corner of this square. I'm then gonna cross over to the upper right-hand corner of this square and pull it through. And then I'm going to cross over and come out from the bottom right-hand corner of this pixel and go back in the upper left-hand corner. So each time I'm going across diagonally, and that is the same motion that we will repeat the entire time throughout this process. So if I flip it over to the back, I've got these two strands that are coming out, and for this one only, I'm going to tie these two strands together, so just like this, and then to make sure that they don't get in the way, I'm going to cut these like so, because we are actually going to end up taking this out when we are at the end of the project. So we flip it over, we can see this stitch here is marking close to where the center of the entire fabric is going to be. Now what we need to do next, so on page number 2 where we can actually see the chart, on the upper right hand corner of that lower left side square, we are going to mark that stitch with the color that we used. And this is what I would call the anchor stitch, because we are going to use this to reference and make sure that we are where we're supposed to be in the chart. It's very easy to get confused later on and a little bit unsure about where we're supposed to be in the chart. So we can always refer back to this and count over or down from it, whatever it is that you need to do to make sure that everything is placed correctly. So to see how this relates, this blue square right here that we've marked is this blue square on the chart. And that is gonna help us get our bearings and understand where we're supposed to place these stitches. So regardless of which pattern you're doing, what I would recommend for the samplers is that you begin by doing the black outline first, then doing the highlight portion, then going in and filling in the rest. Because once you have those two elements in place, you can just fill in this color section with the red. So, the first thing that I will do is take my black embroidery floss and find the end. And I'm gonna get a piece that is about 1 foot long, because I don't want it to tangle like crazy as I'm working. And I'm going to cut that. So on the end, that's gonna be the back end, I'm gonna tie a knot. And another one, and try to make sure that those end up on top of each other, so it's a nice big knot. And then on the other end, I'm going to thread the needle. And with that, I am ready to go. So before I start actually stitching, I have to get this into the hoop like we've done before. So I'm gonna unscrew this latch right here all the way, and then I'm gonna pop this out. Then I have the inner ring. I will place this fabric over top. And as you do this, try to make sure that the center is actually in the center of the ring. And you can see through, it's pretty transparent. After you have that placed, you would then take the outer ring and push it down, just like that. And then gradually start tightening this latch on top. And as you tighten this, I would recommend pulling on the edges to try to get that fabric nice and taut, just like we would have done for embroidery. All right, so on the right side over here, I'm gonna have a picture of the chart so you can understand how what I'm doing over here relates to what I'm doing over there. We see there's this blue stitch right here, and that is marking the center. Like I said, that's our anchor stitch. And including this one, if we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 down, this pixel right here is going to be where we will begin. So once again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that is the stitch that we want to start with. And I will come out from behind and pull very carefully until that knot catches. So you can feel it's nice and taut. You look at the back, we see there's no tangle. Then I will switch over to the upper right-hand corner and pull it through. So we've got that diagonal. Then I'm gonna switch over to the bottom right-hand corner and pull it, making sure not to get a tangle on the back. And I'm gonna cross over diagonally into the upper left-hand corner and pull it through. And we create that little X. Now, the next one, the next stitch that we're gonna do is over one and up one. So we know it's this one right here. So I am then going to go into the lower left-hand corner of that pixel, pull it through very carefully, go into the upper right-hand corner, pull that through, and then once again, the lower right-hand corner, over to the upper left-hand corner and pull that tight. And that is how it is going to be done. Fast forward, I'm on my last stitch. I pull it all the way through. And now I'm ready to fasten off. So I'm gonna turn it to the back side. And on here, we are going to fasten off like we did for embroidery. So we are going to tie a big knot. We're gonna loop it around like that. And then we will place the needle right where that last stitch is coming out of on the back side. And we'll slowly pull the knot tight. And having that needle placed there is going to lead that knot right to the back side. And I like to take my finger here and push it down and pull that end tight. To make sure that that knot is a bit bigger, I like to tie it again, place the needle, pull it, and then when it gets closer, just pull that with my finger. And then I'm gonna cut the tail off, leaving just a bit. I'm not gonna cut too close to the knot because I don't want that to come undone. Another thing, now that I'm at this point, I can undo the anchor stitch because I no longer need that. And with that, we have a finished sampler, so we can pop it out. And that's all there is to it. So hopefully this video helps you understand how this process works. Thank you for watching. Listen what the stars say when I say it's God's way. Tippy torn and I'm a walk. Rolling sevens, I ain't ready for no coffee.